All right, everybody, if you own a Ram Cummins 6.7, at some point in your life, you are going to experience issues with the factory whole set turbo, the VGT one. There's no doubt about that. So you're only gonna have very few options when it comes down to turbo or actuator failure. We'll go from the most expensive to the least expensive is what we did. So we did the least expensive route. The most expensive is going to be going back to the dealership. If you're not under warranty, getting this thing replaced, you're going to be $5,000 easily. The turbo itself is over $3,000. They only do new turbos. They won't sell you the actuator. It's the whole turbocharger and actuator because they come programmed as a unit. Your second option would be to go somewhere and pick up a turbocharger that's remanned with the actuator still on it. Then you'd have to just do the work yourself, swap the turbo in, and send it off. You're good to go. You're still gonna be out around, you know, $2,000 to $3,000 there. The next option, what we did was we pulled the turbo and rebuilt it. Click the link to check out that series above. We rebuilt the turbo, put about 7,600 miles on it. Flawless, nothing's wrong with it. Did the nozzle, the ring, everything. The problem is that original actuator there. When we got the actuator, we bought a cheap one off of Amazon and it did not come with the calibration box. So there wasn't enough time with shipping and a whole lot of issues. So we threw the original one back on and used a scan tool with a downloader program, which we'll show in this video as well. That's all part of the cheapest route to go. We threw it all back together and it worked for 7,500 mile or probably about like 68. Now let me back up. Let's think 75, 65. So we're at about 5,500 miles is when the actuator went out, 5,000 to 5,500. So a couple thousand miles we drove with this actuator going bad and then disconnected at the final 1,000 miles and then it limped it home. Not really limped it, but it made it. It was just building boost slow and low gears and it was erratic shifting. So a common thing people do is take the actuator off, check the swing arm, make sure that it's still in good shape. If it does move in and out, then you probably just need the actuator. And honestly, a good option if you don't have a scan tool is to go with the City Diesel and Gino's Garage one, I believe it is. It comes pre-calibrated. You just basically slap it on and it's supposed to go. Since we have the software, we went again the cheapest route and we bought a Amazon actuator. We'll show you the software. We don't know if it's gonna come with the calibration box. A lot of them do, but you can upgrade this actuator to the 2013 and newer ones with a newer harness, which we are also gonna do because the 2013 ones are supposed to be more reliable. So we're gonna take this airbox out of the way just to show you guys and give you guys some more visual access down there. We're gonna try and do the whole thing while it's on just some ramps. We really don't wanna take it apart. So we'll go from there, we'll get this airbox out of the way and then see what we can do. All right, we cleared out the airbox and now you can see down to the turbo and that's the actuator right there that we're after on the side there. It's got two small Allen bolts on the top and two in the bottom, but we're gonna have to drain the coolant down some to remove that. All right, we drained about half the coolant down. We're under here on the passenger side. We're gonna push the fender well up and you can see the two Allen head bolts right there. I'm gonna go ahead and remove those. All right, we'll remove the turbo actuator, get a bucket down there and collect the mess that's gonna happen. But basically, this arm here should move with one finger fairly easy. And you can hear it. Stop to stop. So these vanes are good. They're swiping good. So we got the new actuator coming in today. Hopefully it'll be here. We'll get all this cleaned up. Make sure everything's dry. We'll go over and look at the actuator real quick. All right, here it is, the whole set turbo actuator. This is the OEM one, about 270,000 miles. We rebuilt the turbo, but did not have a new actuator at the time. So we got about another 7,000 out of this one before it took a dump. Turbo checks out good still, no shaft play, everything's clean in there. We'll wait to get this new actuator, put it on and show you guys how to install it. You know, this is the cheapest way to do it, honestly, and hopefully it works. All right, we got the new actuator in. As you can tell, electrically, it is different. The housings are exactly the same. They'll both up the same, but the electrical side is different. So if you want to use the newer style actuator, you'll have to get a jumper harness to go between the actuator and the engine harness of the truck, which will match up to that one, and it'll bolt in. Other than that, it bolts on exactly the same. There's no grease on these wheels. They didn't send any grease, so we'll probably just leave it as is and send it in. It came with new hardware and new gaskets. We'll get it all bolted in and see how it fits. All right, real quick on the actuator harness, the new one. If you see there, it had some like outside wings or tabs. We just took a razor and sliced them off because they were at a different angle than those ones up there. See those little like half moon things? So we got rid of them and it plugs right in. So that might be an issue on your truck. Just be aware, you can just cut those little tabs off and it'll go right in. All right, guys, we got the actuator hooked up. We have the truck hooked up to an OBD Link MX Plus running through Alpha OBD. We will do a separate video on this software, guys. If you own a Ram or any Chrysler product at that, this is fantastic software to have. We're gonna go through the Turbo VGT pre-align and self-calibrate, which is here. And it's saying for us to turbo self-calibrate. Before continuing, ensure that the coolant has been drained and the VGT actuator is removed from the turbocharger. If the removal step is not completed prior to continuing, damaging the actuator will occur because it's looking for home. So we're going to hit start. It's going to give you one more warning. And we're going to click OK. Okay, now it's telling us to install it. Forgot to mention, when installing this VGT actuator, make sure it's dry down there and the arm is all the way towards the firewall or to the left, the back of the turbocharger towards the exhaust. It has to be in that position for this thing to do the calibration properly. We're gonna get all the bolts in now. All right, we got the actuator snugged down. We're gonna go ahead and start the calibration. We can hear it moving. All right, calibration completed. So that means it's done. Simple, easy. So we're gonna go back now and we're gonna do the clean test. We're gonna do the self-calibrate. So we pre-aligned it and it's installed. Now we're gonna do the self-align calibrate. And you can hear it buzzing around down there. And it's completed. That's it. Easy, simple install. You can save yourself thousands. We'll have the links for everything in the description.